I am Satish Gaonkar. Today I am solving the problem of mechanics of material. In that one, volumetric strain. In the volumetric strain, a rectangular bar, a steel bar of 300 mm length, cross section is 30 mm into 30 mm, is subject to an axial tensile force of 150 kN along its length. Determine the change in volume and take Young's modulus 200 kN meter per mm square and Poisson's ratio is 0.3. A rectangular bar is given. Rectangular bar of length is L is equal to 300 mm. Length is given. Cross section area is 30 mm to 30 mm, thickness and width. I will consider this as a width. This one as a thickness and this one as a width. And this is the length. And tension is applied. Tensile force is applied. Tensile force P is equal to 150 into 10 raised to 3 Newton is applied. Either side, P is equal to 50 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. What we have to find out? We have to find out change in volume, that is delta V. Change in volume we have to find out. Change in volume. E is equal to 200 into 10 raised to 3. We have to convert into Newton per mm square. It is kilo. Therefore, 10 raised to 3. Mu is, or 1 by m is nothing but 0.3, Poisson's ratio. Now, for rectangular section, we arrived a formula. Volumetric strain, EV is equal to sigma divided by E, 1 minus 2 mu. 1 minus 2 mu. Where EV is equal to, what is stress? Stress is nothing but P by A. P divided by area divided by Young's modulus, 1 minus 2 mu. 1 minus 2 mu. P is given here. P is, EV is equal to, P value is 150 into 10 raised to 3. What about the area? The tension is given only over this area. Therefore, you have to consider the area of this part, only this part. Don't consider the volume. Only you have to consider the area. That means 30 into 30. If the tension is acting this side, then you have to consider only area of this part. That means 300 into 30. If the tension is acting here, then you have to consider the area. That means 300 into 30. Now, the tension acting here, therefore you have to consider only this area. Area divided by Young's modulus, 200 into 10 raised to 3. 10 raised to 3, 1 minus 2 mu. Mu is nothing but 2 into 0.3. If you calculate the value, or instead of EV, what is EV? EV is nothing but delta V by V. We have to find out change in volume. You can go for it. Delta V by V. What is V? V is nothing but the initial volume. What is the initial volume for rectangular section? That is W into T into L. W into T into L. V is nothing but W, T, L. You will get the initial volume. Substitute here. 30 into 300 is equal to 150 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 30 into 30 divided by 200 into 10 raised to 3 into 1 minus 2 into 0.3. With the help of calculator, you can find out this. Mod phi, alpha x divided by 30 into 30 into 300, alpha sol is equal to, therefore alpha sol, if you press it, it becomes is equal to 150 into 10 raised to 3 30 into 30 divided by 200. 200 into 10 raised to 3 into 1 divided by 1 minus 2 into 0.3. Then you have to press shift solve is equal to. Shift solve is equal to. The answer is delta V is equal to 90. It is a volumetric strain. Volume, if it is a volume comes in picture, therefore you have to write as mm raised to cube. This is the volumetric strain. Change in volume. Delta V. This is the volumetric strain. Okay. I will consider second problem. A rectangular bar of size 50 mm width, 50 mm width, 12 mm thickness and 300 mm length. A rectangular bar is given. A rectangular bar length is 300 mm, L is equal to 300 mm. Width, thickness, this is the thickness. Thickness is nothing but 12 mm. And width is nothing but 50 mm. This is the width. Now, acting a tensile pull, is acting here. P, which is nothing but 84 into 10 raised to 3. In terms of Newton, P is equal to 84 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Determine the change in length. What we have to find out? Delta L we have to find out. Next, delta W we have to find out. Width. Next, delta T we have to find out. And delta V, the change in volume we have to find out. Given. Young's modulus E is equal to 200 GPa. We have to convert into Newton per mm square. Therefore, multiply with 10 raised to 3. It convert into Newton per mm square. The Poisson's ratio is given. Mu or 1 by m is equal to 0.32. Now, first, we are going to find out change in volume. We know that the volumetric strain EV is equal to sigma divided by E. 1 minus 2 mu. EV is equal to, what is sigma? P by A divided by E. 1 minus 2 into 0.32. Delta V, EV can be written as delta V divided by V. In place of P, 84 into 10 raised to 3. What is the area? You have to consider only the area of this part. 50 into 12. Divided by Young's modulus 200 into 10 raised to 3 into 1 minus 2 into 0.32. Now what is the volume, initial volume? Volume will be 12 into 50 into 300. This is the volume. Right here, delta V is equal to 12 into 50 into 300 is equal to 84 into 10 raised to 3. Divided by 50 into 12 divided by 200 into 10 raised to 3 into 1 minus 2 into 0.32. With the help of calculator, you can find out directly. That means alpha x divided by 12 into 50 into 300 alpha sol is equal to 84 into 10 raised to 3 by 50 into 12 divided by 200 into 10 raised to 3 into 1 minus 2 into 0.32. Now shift solve is equal to the volumetric strain, sorry, change in volume change in volume, delta V is nothing but 45.36 mm cube. Now we got the change in volume. We have to find out delta L. We know that in the derivation, instead of by S, we can write it as sigma EV is equal to delta L divided by L 1 minus 2 mu. In place of sigma divided by E, we can write it delta L by L. In terms of this value, substitute here and substitute here. Delta V divided by volume is equal to delta L divided by L 1 minus 2 mu. What is divided by 12 into 50 into 300 is equal to delta L divided by L. What is L value? Into 1 minus 2 into 0.32. You can find out delta L value. 45.36 divided by 12 into 50 into 300. Alpha is equal to alpha x divided by 300 into 1 minus 2 into 0.32. Shift solve is equal to delta L value will be 0.21 mm. Now we have to find out delta W value and delta T value. How to find out delta W value? It total depends upon the Poisson's ratio. What is Poisson's ratio says? Poisson's ratio says lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Lateral by longitudinal strain. This term delta L, this part we call as a longitudinal strain as per the derivation. Now mu value they have given it 0.32. Lateral strain. Now lateral strain here refer as reduction in the width and the thickness. I will consider lateral W, delta W divided by W divided by delta L by L, lateral strain divided by longitudinal strain. Now substitute the value here, delta L, delta W, we don't know. What is W? 50 divided by delta L, 0.21 divided by length is 300. Now 0.32 alpha sol, one more alpha x divided by 50, 0.21 divided by 300. Shift sol is equal to, the answer is, answer for W is delta W will be 0.0112 mm. Similarly, we are going to solve for the delta T. 0.32 is equal to delta T divided by delta L by L. Delta T divided by thickness will be 12 divided by 0.21 divided by 300. Now, just replace single value, that is 12, 50. 50 has to be replaced with 12. Shift solve is equal to, the answer is for T will be, T is 2.688 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. In this way you have to find out the length, width, thickness and volume. I am going to solve one more problem here. Determine the change in length, width and thickness similar to that of the previous problem. First I will draw a box here, a rectangular box. Length is given as 4 meter. We have to convert into terms of mm. L is equal to 4000 mm. The width is 30 mm. W is equal to 30 mm. Thickness is 20 mm. T is equal to 20 mm. Subjected to an axial pull. Axial pull P is equal to 30 into 10 raised to 3. P is equal to 30 into 10 raised to 3 newton. The length is given newton in the direction of length. Young's modulus is given 2 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm square. Poisson's ratio mu or m, 1 by m is nothing but 0.3. We have to determine the volumetric strain. Volumetric strain is nothing but EV, we have to determine it. Change in volume, delta V, we have to find out. Final volume we have to find out. Final volume is nothing but delta V plus V. Change in volume plus initial volume, we will get the final volume of a given bar. Now let's first, I am going to find out the volumetric strain, EV. EV is equal to sigma divided by E, 1 minus 2 mu. Sigma is nothing but P by A divided by E, 1 minus 2 mu. This is the volumetric strain, denoted by volumetric strain. Now further, P is nothing but 30 into 10 raised to 3. Area is nothing but 30 into 20, because it's acting here. The force is acting over this area. You have to consider only this part. 30 into 20 divided by Young's modulus 2 into 10 raised to 5 into 1 minus 2 into 0.3. If you solve it, the answer will be 1 into 10 raised to minus 4. It is a strain. The unit, there will be no unit. Then you have to find out delta V. EV is equal to delta V divided by V. 1 into 10 raised to minus 4 is equal to delta V. What is volume? Initial volume. Volume will be 20 into 30 into 400. This is the initial volume. V will be 30 into 20 into 400. You will get the volume. 4000. Cross multiply, you will get delta V is equal to 240 mm cube. We got the change in volume. Now we are going to find out the final volume. Final volume is equal to delta V plus V, 240 plus 30 into 20 plus, sorry, into 4000. Calculate 240 mm cube. Volume, if the volume comes in picture, then you have to go for mm cube. Now we got the volumetric strain, change in volume and final volume. Simultaneously, we have to find out the change in length also. Find out change in length, that means delta L you have to find out. Delta omega, delta W we have to find out. And delta T we have to find out. Now we are going to find out delta L. What is delta L? Replace sigma E by delta L. As per the derivation, EV is equal to delta L by L 1 minus 2 mu. E already they have given it, already we have obtained it. 1 into 10 raised to minus 4 delta L, the L value is 4000. 1 minus 2 into 1 minus 2 into 0.3. If you calculate, delta L will be 1 mm. Delta L will be 1 mm. Now, we are going to find out delta W. In order to find out delta W, we have to go for Poisson's ratio. Mu is equal to lateral strain divided by longitudinal strain. That means 0.3 is equal to delta W divided by W is equal to delta L by L. This part we call as a longitudinal strain. Substitute the value delta W divided by 30 into delta L will be 1 divided by 4000 and delta W will be 2.25 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. Similarly, go for finding the thickness. Thickness 0.3 divided by delta T divided by delta L divided by L. That means delta T divided by 20 divided by 1 divided by 4000. If you cross multiply, then the delta T will be 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. In this way, you have to solve the problem of volumetric strain when it is subjected to rectangular and single force is provided. I am Santosh Gajankar. Thank you very much.